If the patient has problems with his jaw joint, then you can say temporomandibular joint disorder, or a little more easier for the patient to understand, jaw joint disorder. Now you've done a checkup, you've examined your patient, and you've come to a conclusion, and you want to communicate that to your patient. That's why I've brought along vocabulary about the diseases and disorders of the oral cavity. If the teeth are standing extremely close together, then we say crowded teeth. Das ist engstand. The gums all around the teeth are inflamed. Then we are talking about inflammation of the gums, something your patient will understand well, or gingivitis. The next one is a fractured tooth or fractured teeth. If you can see a lot of the roots, then we're talking about gum disease or periodontal disease. In this case, the gums have receded away from the teeth. One of the classics in dentistry is caries or tooth decay. And a great word to use for people who are not so familiar with English is to talk about the hole in the tooth, which is also a great word to use when you're speaking with kids. Ein devitaler Zahn is a non-vital tooth. The gums have grown excessively, then we're talking about overgrowth of the gums, or more technical term, gingival hyperplasia. There is a buildup of plaque under the gum line, then we're talking about subgingival plaque. If the patient has problems with his jaw joint, then you can say temporomandibular joint disorder, or a little more easier for the patient to understand, jaw joint disorder. Dann haben wir den Abszess. It's short and simple, the abscess. And last but not least, we're talking about a cyst. So now you have all the words you need to diagnose your patient. Thank you for watching this video. Please like it and subscribe our channel. More about me you'll find below underneath in the description.